It is hard to imagine AI today without transformers. Transformers are the backbone architecture behind large language models that have revolutionized AI. But transformers' influence is not limited to natural language processing. Transformers are also crucial in other domains, such as computer vision, where vision transformers play a significant role. However, as we move forward, models grow larger, and when it happens, there is a need to train the model from scratch. This process gets increasingly costly and unsustainable, and even raising environmental concerns. Every so often, I come across a paper that's simply beautiful, and that's the case here. Today's paper is titled Tokenformer, Rethinking Transformer Scaling with Tokenized Model Parameters, and it suggests a fascinating change to the transformer architecture, which eliminates the need to retrain the model from scratch when increasing model size, saving a dramatic part of the cost where the new architecture is named Tokenformer. Let's start with a high-level comparison between the transformer architecture to the Tokenformer architecture using the following figure from the paper. On the left, we have a simplified view of the original transformer architecture. Given an input sequence of tokens which we have at the bottom, we first pass the input via a linear projection block to calculate the inputs for the attention block, the matrices Q, K, and V. In this phase, we have interactions between the model parameters and the input tokens, which are calculated using a linear projection. Then, we have the self-attention component, where input tokens interact with each other. So, token-token interactions are calculated via an attention block. Finally, to produce the output for the next layer, we have a feed-forward network. This again represents interactions between tokens and parameters, which are calculated using linear projections. We see that token-parameter interactions are calculated via linear projections components, which hold a fixed size of parameters, which requires training from scratch when increasing model size. The main idea with Tokenformer is to create a fully attention-based model, also for token-parameter interactions, to have a more flexible architecture that can support incremental increases of parameters count. We review it now in high level and later on dive deeper. First, to calculate the inputs for the self-attention block, the Q, K, and V matrices, we feed the input tokens into a new component called token-parameter-attention. In addition to the input tokens, we also pass parameters to the token-parameter-attention block. The input sequence represents the query part, and there are parameters that represent the key and value parts of the token-parameter-attention block. Then, we have the same self-attention component as before, but in order to prepare the output for the next layer, we now replace the feed-forward network with another token-parameter-attention block, where the output from the self-attention block is used as the query, and we again have different parameters for the key and value matrices. If you're finding this content valuable, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button to support the channel. We also send 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. Let's now zoom in into the Tokenformer architecture by reviewing the following figure from the paper. At the top, we have the input tokens. After normalization, the input tokens are passed to three potention blocks, where potention is the name of the token parameter attention block. Each of the three potention blocks has its own weights, and they are in charge of creating the inputs for the self-attention blocks, the Q, K, and V matrices, one per each potention block. On the right, we can see what happens in each potention block. Recall the original attention block is calculated using the following equation, where the Q and K matrices are multiplied, then scaled down and normalized with a softmax, and the result is then multiplied by the V matrix. The Tokenformer potential equation is very similar. The input tokens are used as the query, and the key and value matrices are given by parameters of the potential block. Instead of the softmax and scaling factor in the original attention, there is a modified softmax with different scaling mechanism to improve the optimization stability, which is represented by the theta function. So the first part of the modified softmax of x multiplied by k is represented by matching between the input tokens to the key parameters matrix, which gives us the attention scores, which are then weighted using the V parameters matrix to generate the final output from this block. Okay? Going back to the flow, we forward the outputs from the potential blocks to the standard self-attention block. Afterwards, instead of a feed-forward network, we have two more sequential potential blocks, where between them we merge with the input tokens via a residual connection. So this is how a layer in a tokenformer operates, and on the bottom right, we can see an illustration for what happens when we want to increase the model size incrementally by adding new parameters. We basically append more parameter token rows to the key and value matrices in each potential block, but keeping the trained parameter tokens, then all tokens keep on being updated when training the larger model, and we'll see in the results that models which are incremented in size are trained much faster comparing to training from scratch. So let's move on to see some of the results presented in the paper. In the following figure from the paper, we can see tokenformer models' performance on the y-axis and training cost on the x-axis comparing to a transformer which is trained from scratch. The blue line represents the transformer models which were trained from scratch using 300 billion tokens, where the different circle sizes represent the different model sizes listed with gray circles in the middle. The other lines represent tokenformer models, where each color is different in the number of tokens used to train the incremented versions. Looking at the red line, for example, it starts with 124 million parameters and incrementally scaled up to 1.4 billion parameters using 30 billion tokens out of the 300 billion tokens used to train from scratch. The final version is comparable in performance to the transformer of the same size, but with dramatically less training cost. In the yellow line, using 60 billion tokens to train the incremented versions, we already reach better performance comparing to the transformer, still with lower training cost. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.